This week on One Devotion, a promising rookie takes his family's basketball roots to a fourth country. The reigning Euroleague champs recount how they ended their long years of waiting. A pair of teammates match wits and quickness behind the scenes at their club. And a son of South America tells how basketball was with him almost from birth. They say the waiting is the hardest part, and for the last Euroleague champion, that wait had been very long indeed. As the 2014-15 season dawned, not only was its previous continental title almost 20 years old, but Real Madrid had lost the last two championship games, despite big leads in each. Now, with the Final Four headed to its home court, doubters questioned whether Madrid's eye-pleasing style under head coach Pablo Laso was truly the stuff of champions.
You know, ever since Pablo came here, you know, he gave guys like Sergi Yule and Sergio Rodriguez the opportunity to do what they do well. You know, whether it's zoom up and down the court and get guys the ball, or to pass it all over the place and get guys alley-oops and open shots. You know, he lets us all play within our system how we're capable of playing. And for us, that's up-tempo, that's 3-point shots, alley-oops and dunks and that kind of thing.
To its super-talented roster captained by warrior Felipe Reyes, Madrid had added an extra layer of toughness before the season with sturdy big man Gustavo Ayón and a small forward nicknamed the Bull, Jonas Masiulis. Also new to the task, veteran Andres Nocioni had waited many years for his own EuroLeague title opportunity. He understood exactly why anything but a EuroLeague trophy would not be enough for his new team last season.
I feel like it was probably my last opportunity because I'm 36, so I'm kind of thinking about maybe it's my last chance to get this tournament.
Being the team to beat did not bother Madrid as it won its regular season and top 16 groups. Then, a four-game victory over Anadolu Efes Istanbul in the playoffs set up a semi-final date with Final Four newcomer Fenerbahce Istanbul and the man who had coached Madrid to its last EuroLeague trophy in 1995. Željko Obradović, the most successful coach in European history, had Fenerbahce playing well. But 35 second-quarter points by Madrid turned their semi-final into a one-way street that delighted the home fans. Madrid led by 27 points after half-time and tied a Final Four record by making 14 three-point shots.
We had a couple guys, Gustavo Ayón, that had a monster game, and then Casey Rivers that made some, you know, shot lights out from three. And a team that came in as kind of a big time favorite, I felt like Fenerbahce, to be able to win as like we did with the margin of victory that we had was pretty incredible.
The victory set up a rematch of the 2013 title game when Olympiakos Piraeus and Vasilis Panoulis came back from 17 points behind to beat Madrid and lift the trophy. This time, Lazo's defense kept Spanoulis in check for 40 minutes. Olympiakos still rallied for a 40-41 third quarter lead, but that's when Carroll made a huge triple and felt a rare magic that only the great shooters know.
I was dying to shoot the ball again, I'll be honest. I was dying to get it. And I came off and I went up to shoot and it was contested and I passed it to Marcus. And as soon as he threw it back to me, I knew I was shooting it again.
A third three-pointer and a subsequent layup gave Carroll 11 points in a 90-second span that put Madrid in control of the scoreboard again, this time for good.
That was, you know, a little three-minute stretch when everything kind of went my way. It went the way you hope in a championship game.
The final blow was delivered by Nocioni. His late block and three-pointers added to the energy, hustle and toughness that he brought to the floor all weekend, and that prompted him to be voted the Final Four MVP.
We got the really talented team, and we have a lot of individual talent, so I try to give something different on the team, and I think it's really special for me the way how I get the MVP, because it was the same way that I used to play in all my life, so that feels great.
For those like Carroll who had pushed all decade to get Madrid to the pinnacle, the celebration was well worth the wait.
Defensively, we were really tough. We were physical. We didn't let them intimidate us. And you know, finally, after three straight Final Fours, we were able to be champs. Having had that experience 2 years previously in a row, it definitely made the third time a lot more sweet for me. I can remember all those bad feelings, and to have the good feelings overcome it was really huge.
Adding to the satisfaction was the fact that, despite summoning the defensive toughness required, Madrid was as entertaining as ever, as it scored the third most points by the champion at a Final Four this century.
It was a good feeling to know that this method, the style of play that Pablo's tried to let us do for the last 5 years, could win championships and could win the big game.
Coming from a basketball crazy family, you have only been surprised if Jason Granger of Anadolu Efes Istanbul didn't take to the court himself. But he tells us now that is nearly what happened, because in his younger days in Uruguay, he started off by playing a completely different sport.
How many players I had? My dad playing basketball, my mom, my brother, my sister, all my cousins, and my uncle. And I started playing soccer because I was born in Uruguay, so it's a soccer country, so I started playing soccer, but then I moved to basketball. My parents always tell me, do whatever you want. If you want to do sports, you can play basketball, you can play soccer, whatever you want, whatever you feel good. So I started playing soccer because all the people in school was playing soccer, all my neighbors were playing soccer, so I was pretty good too. But then I was just get tired because all my life was around basketball. So I decided to switch it up when I was like seven, eight years old. I was more with a basketball in my hands. Even my dad and my mom, they were professional basketball players. And since I was one year old, I was in my bed with shooting to the trash with a piece of paper. So I was born out of living a love for basketball. Me and my dad, I was going with him to practice, every game. I was with the basketball under my arm. I was following him everywhere. He's really competitive. Even if we're still trying to play one-on-one right now, he's trying to cheat or trying to foul me, trying to do dirty stuff.
The drama continued in Top 16, Round 5. Here's how the action unfolded all over Europe. Fenerbahce overcame Cerevita, Cervena Zvezda powered past Lokomotiv, Panathinaikos edged out Darušafaka, and FS1 in Malaga. In Group E, Cerevita Zagreb travelled to Fenerbahce looking for a fifth road win of the season. The home team raced out to an early double-digit advantage behind Epe Udo and Ricky Hickman. But Cedevita fought back to make it a one-point game after three quarters. Fenerbahce raced clear in the fourth, with Luigi Datome hitting the big shots to secure another victory for the unbeaten Turkish team. Attempting to stay in second place, Lokomotiv travelled to Cervena Zvezda, but quickly found themselves trailing heavily as Quincy Miller scored 14 points in the first quarter. and the hosts kept their foot on the gas, maintaining a safe distance as Terence Kinsey scored 19 points. Panathinaikos and Darussafaka contested a close battle, which never saw either team lead by double digits. 26 points from Jamont Gordon kept the visitors in contention until the final seconds. But big contributions from Nick Kalathis and Miroslav Radulica just allowed Panathinaikos to prevail. Another close game was fought out between Unikaha and Anadolu Efes, with Richard Hendricks leading the charge for the home team. But Jason Granger made the difference against his former club, scoring 22 points before defense took over to hold Unikaha scoreless in the final minutes, giving Efes a vital road win. Fenerbahce remains perfect at the top of the group, now two games ahead of Efes, Crvena Zvezda and Lokomotiv. Unikaha, Panathinaikos and Cedevita are in hot pursuit, with Darussafaka still seeking its first win. CSKA Moscow breezed past Bamberg, Real Madrid defeated Olympiakos, Laboral won after overtime in Barcelona and Himki blasted away Žalgiris. In Group F, CSKA Moscow played Brose Baskets Bamberg for the third time this season, and the visitors scored the first 10 points of the game. But it was all CSKA the rest of the way, as Nando Decolo led the hosts in a huge second quarter run. CSKA never looked back from that moment, cruising to its third win over Bamberg this season. In a rematch of last season's final, visiting Olympiakos and Real Madrid traded leads in the first half. But Madrid started firing from long range after the break as Sergio Rodriguez and Sergio Llull took over, and the Spanish team eventually won with comfort. At home to Žalgiris, Tyrese Rice was in inspirational form for group leaders Himki, delivering 9 assists in the first half and also hitting 5 triples to earn the weekly MVP award, leading his team to a club record points tally and a blowout victory. In Barcelona, Laboral Cucha led most of the way, but 21 points from Alex Sabrines spearheaded the home team's comeback, which nearly resulted in victory, until Darius Adams forced overtime with a late triple. The extra period was Laboral's as Ioannis Borussis finished with 24 points to help his team claim an impressive road win. Himki Moscow holds on to first place after winning all 4 games in this phase. CSKA Moscow, Laboral Cucha and Real Madrid are all just 1 game behind, followed by Bamberg, Barcelona and Olympiakos. With basketball virtually running through his veins as part of a family that has spread its roots in the sport to 3 different countries, 20-year-old forward Alexander Vezenkov is trying to take that legacy a step further with his new team, FC Barcelona Lassa. In this, his rookie season in the Turkish Airlines Euroleague, Alexander shares the Barcelona locker room with some Euroleague legends and faces off against many others each week. But there is still one player he looks up to more than any other, his father.
He is my role model. He advised me every time, every game. He made me to start playing basketball, him and my sister. So I'm very proud of him, and he's proud of me too.
Alexander's father, Sasho Vezenkov, is a Bulgarian basketball legend. He was a captain of the Bulgarian national team during his playing days, and later on sports director of Bulgarian powerhouse Lukoil Akademik. But the younger Vezenkov story doesn't begin in the same country. He was born in Cyprus, where his father finished his career. His older sister, Michaela, played for the Cypriot women's national team and made the Vezenkov family a part of basketball history with team captains for 2 different countries.
Like, my father was a legend in Bulgaria. He was playing like the 80s. My sister played the last decade. So we're proud of every country. Like, we were born in Cyprus. So both Cyprus and Bulgaria are like my countries and Greece. So yeah, I'm proud of it.
Cyprus is also a place where Alexander took his first basketball steps, playing for youth categories in Apoel Nicosia. He wasn't always sure if he liked basketball, and only when he briefly stopped playing did he realize how much he missed it. His development took off when he moved to Greece to join Aris Thessaloniki.
When I was 15, I went to Greece. I wanted to go to more basketball country from Cyprus. So I knocked the door to the Aris people, but they didn't know me back then. So they say no. So I tried to go to one school, Mandoulidis school, but just 2 minutes before I signed, Aris president called me and he said, "We want you." So Aris is a big club with big history, so you cannot reject to this team.
Vezenkov made plenty of noise with Aris, going from a promising teenager to one of the best young players in world basketball. He has been named the best young player in Greece for 3 years and led the Greek league in scoring last season while still a teenager. This season, Vezenkov wasted little time to break into the regular rotation for Barcelona under head coach Xavi Pascual.
It's my first year in Euroleague, so I'm very happy about it. I'm proud to be part in such a big organization and such a big club like Barcelona. I'll give everything for the team to accomplish their goals. So I have a little bit stress because it's my first year, I'm a rookie, and my family is very proud about it.
Vezenkov reached a Euroleague career-high 15 points in regular season road win against Stenmet Zielona-Gora. As a modern power forward who can shoot and stretch defenses, even in limited minutes so far, he has made at least one three-pointer in more than half of the Euroleague games he has played. It might be a sign of the big things to come from the young forward, but it also suggests that even though Alexander might have followed his father's basketball steps, he hasn't molded his game after him.
I don't think we're similar players because he plays with a lot of contact, a lot inside of the paint. I like to play more outside.
At 2 meters 6, with soft hands and a knack for scoring baskets, Vezenkov has all the tools to become a big name on the basketball scene, but also has a father by his side to be there for him every step of the way.
He's always there to me, to help me, to advise me, to tell me what I did wrong first, and then to say me bravo for what I did good.
Although his basketball DNA touches on three countries, and he's now playing in a fourth, his respect for his family legacy led Vezenkov to decide on Bulgaria as the national team he will represent, even though he has never lived there.
I was born in Cyprus. I play almost my whole life in Greece. So I'm their product, so it was tough. But my father and mother are from Bulgaria. We take the decision when I was 15, so since they're from Bulgaria, I should represent this country.
Time for scavenger hunt, and let's meet today's explorers.
Hi, I'm Ender Arslan from Darüşşafaka Doğuş.
Hello, I'm Serhat Çetin from Darüşşafaka Doğuş.
First task, find me something round that's not a basketball.
This is round. I found it at the office. This is from Dubai. Some souvenir.
Yep, that's worth a point.
Does it count?
Find something made of glass.
This is Turkish tea glass. I found it
on the next two.
Very good, 1 point each.
Now this time he was faster than me.
Find something to read. Very quick.
This?
I think at the same time.
What is this?
Yeah, 1 point each.
This is a contract.
Find something to eat. It looks like Serhat won this one.
He's more strong. He pushed me.
It doesn't matter, he won.
This is a challenge. What can you do sometimes?
Find an old thing.
And this is the winner.
Who's this, Ender?
Our physiotherapist.
Where's Serhat?
Nice to meet you.
You know, I think you have to choose who wins because this guy's, how old are you?
40. 42.
He's 52.
It doesn't matter. We want a thing, not a person. Nobody wins. But Serhat, you're the winner.
Equal.
He's the reigning Euro Cup MVP and a former Euroleague Final Four MVP. And now, Himki Moscow region guard Tyrese Rice is the Euroleague MVP of the week too. Rice claimed the honour for the first time in Top 16 Round 5 after leading Himki to a 111-80 victory over Žalgiris Kaunas with a performance index rating of 35, comfortably the highest among all players in this week's games. Rice amassed 20 points on a 5 of 8 three-point shooting, also making 5 of 6 free throws. And Rice dished 11 assists as well as collecting 2 steals in setting a career high in index rating and leading Himki to a new club record for scoring. Rice ended the game with more points, more assists and more fouls drawn than any other player. And his outstanding efforts played the key role in keeping Himki Moscow region at the top of Group F.
Number 5, Madrid, Spain. Yanis Papapetru for Olympiacos. Over Gustavo Eon and to the rim. Throwing down the dunk with authority, Yanis Papapetru. Number 4, Moscow, Russia. Olivier Hanlon bursts to the basket, but what a block. Kimki's Tyler Honeycutt appears from nowhere, jams it against the glass and catches it himself. Number 3, Athens, Greece. Nick Kalathis in the transition for Panathinaikos. Sends up the shot, misses. James Gist takes the ball low and quick as a flash. His fast hands throw it up for a put-back slam. Number 2, Istanbul, Turkey. James White for Cedevita Zagreb going all the way. Straight to the basket, the most direct route over Jan Vesely and explodes the slam. Number 1, Barcelona, Spain. Pau Ribas to Alex Abrines. And Abrines! High-flying finish from Barcelona's Alex Abrines. Fantastic slam dunk for the play of the week.
As the top 16 nears its midway point, round 6 promises spectacular action that includes a game of the week between a rising power against a traditional heavyweight and an eagerly awaited local derby. In Group E, Istanbul is the venue as Anadolu Efes and versatile Derek Brown square off against Fenerbahce and another high-octane performer, Epe Udo, as the two local rivals play for crosstown bragging rights and much more besides, with Fenerbahce having won all 4 of their previous Euroleague clashes this century. In the same group, two more playoff-chasing teams go head-to-head as Unicaja Malaga and Duero Mindaugas Kuzminskas welcome Lokomotiv Kuban Krasnodar and the inspirational Malcolm Delaney for the first showdown ever between the teams. Also in Group E, Cedevita welcomes Panathinaikos to Zagreb and Crvena Zvezda travels to Istanbul to face Darüşşafaka. The game of the week comes from Group F, where Brose Baskets Bamberg and the energetic Bradley Wanamaker hope to maintain their impressive push for a playoff berth as they seek a first victory ever against FC Barcelona and the visitors' own exciting point man, Tomas Satoranski. Two more teams with playoff expectations meet in Piraeus, where Olympiakos and the ever-consistent Georgios Printezis will relish their confrontation with reigning Euro Cup champions Himki Moscow and another battle-hardened veteran, Sergei Monia. Group F also features a Spanish derby as Real Madrid hosts Laboral Cucha, while CSKA Moscow goes on the road to face Žalgiris Kaunas. We'll see you next week with more EuroLeague action.